So Paradox just revealed their new expansion for Hearts of Iron 4, Götterdämmerung. And I think that, at least from a historical perspective, it's really interesting, so let's check it out.
Subjects and brave warriors of the German Empire. How right now.
Is this him? I actually don't think so. So maybe you can replace him now, which would be very interesting. So this is maybe out of context, but I think this is the narrator of the Napoleon Turtle War trailer.
My enemies are many. My equals are none.
Yup, that's him.
I'll dominate Europe. Gentlemen. A testament to the power and resolve of the German nation.
So this one here is actually interesting because, as you can probably think, it was never built. This is the P-1000 Ratte, but it existed on paper. So here you have a giant tank with two 28cm guns, actually the same ones used on the Scharnhorst-class battleship. And honestly, it would have been of little use during the war. But he was a big fan of the design, so If they had the resources for that, I think it would have been actually built. Of course, it's difficult to say if it could be built, because they plan to power it with 4 submarine engines. I don't know if this would have been enough, but I think this is going to be fun in Hearts of Iron 4. I have this guy here. I think they just put him here so he can compare the size, because if you would actually stand between these guns, as I have said, the same ones used in the Scharnhorst-class battleship, you would be obliterated. This one is also interesting because this is the Volkshalle, or People's Hall, which would have been the heart piece of the new German capital, Germania, which would have been built on the place where now Berlin is. But the difficult thing about this is that as this would have been very tall, here's like a size comparison with the Berlin Castle, so it would have been nearly 300 meters high. It would have been very heavy, and I don't know if you know that, but Berlin was actually built on a swamp. So as you can see on this map from the Middle Ages, this is Berlin, this is Köln, both cities would form what is now Berlin, but around them is only wetlands, and basically it's just a swamp similar to St. Petersburg. So they did not know if the ground could actually carry the weight of the building, and in order to test this, they made the Belastungskörper, or pressure body. And the result of this was that it would be very difficult to build it, because this Belastungskörper sank in several centimeters in only 2 years. But wait, here's, I have another sketch of this. Here you have like a giant triumph arc, and here's the Great Hall. So similar, this one here is very similar to the Champs-Élysées in Paris, but much, much bigger. Yeah, this would have been built if they had won the war, because he was also a very big fan of this design. This was actually his dream. But was never built.
One by one, the mighty have fallen.
German battleships in front of Manhattan.
The burdens.
If you count, these are way more than Germany had during the Second World War. And they also look very, very heavy. Maybe you can build these heavy battleships that were actually planned, which would have been much bigger than the Tirpitz and the Bismarck.
Of their side are being paid back.
This one is actually not that far off, because the Germans built several thousand V2 missiles, 6,000 in total, and half of them were actually fired on Britain, so this is not that far off. But maybe we're going to get bigger missiles. Here you can see the Aggregat 9 and 10, the Amerika Rakete. These ones were actually supposed to have a range that would allow them to be shot on America, but they were never built. And the German leadership also suppressed the development, because they said this is just a waste of resources. But Werner von Braun continued anyway.
fear of our enemies.
It is German science
that has sharpened our dagger.
Maybe you can build this city now and it gives you some advantages.
And it is German science that will deliver.
The nuclear bomb. So this is actually a very difficult topic because there are a lot of myths regarding the development of a German nuclear bomb. There's actually a book which says that they even tested a dirty bomb, but I think that most of these stories are very exaggerated. But apparently now you can build the bomb and drop them on Allied territory, which is going to be interesting.
Our final strike.
Blowing up the White House. I think that you could also have to get a bomber that can carry the bomb across the ocean. There were actually plans for some, but yeah, they also only existed on paper. Yeah, this looks really fun. Here we also have the Horten 229. It was like a German Nurflügler jet fighter, very ahead of its time. But I think there were wooden mock-ups of this, but it was also never developed. But yeah, this looks fun. I'm going to get this.